Monica for Craftin Desert Divas here. And today we're gonna be going over the stitched number dies. Now, this is the corresponding die to the stitched alpha dies. And as you can see, this has wonderful stitch detailing all along the edge. Now, this differs from the alpha dies in the fact that the stitch detailing offers a dash dot dot, where the alpha only offers a dash dot. So it's a single dot on the alpha set. These are wafer thin dies that can be used with most any die cutting machine. As you can see here, I've already taken some samples, and the impression that is left by the stitching is actually quite lovely. I really enjoyed this. Now, these are perfect for aged birthday cards. So those are your birthday cards that say happy first birthday, second birthday, and then in coordination with the alpha dies makes quite a lovely sled. Let's go ahead and separate out our dies. Now we're gonna trim at the tabs here, and you can do that one of two ways, using wire clippers, or you can fold them back and forth until they separate from one another. I prefer using my wire cutters. And I like getting as close as possible to the edge or to the die, so it doesn't leave much of a tab, and this way it won't damage your paperwork as you're cutting. Now let me show you the second way, which is actually folding your dies back and forth on the tab until it separates. Very easy. Now we're ready to set up our sandwich and cut out our paper. So I'm going to start with the A plate. And then I'm going to put down my C plate or my cutting plate with the paper on top, placing the dies face down so that it trims the paper neatly. Now you can arrange it or tape it down so that they don't move. These are wafer thin dies that can be used on most die cutting machines. And all of them have release holes just in case your paper gets stuck in the die. Let's go ahead and take a look. I'm going to move away my cuddle bug and clear out my workspace. So here we go. From time to time, my cuts get stuck in the die, just as they did in this case. So let me just go ahead and flip these over, and then I'll be able to show you how I release them from the die using the release holes that are located on the die itself. So as you can see here, it's stuck in there. I'm just gonna take my sharp tweezers and poke them right through the holes that are located here on the back and release my cut. And one, two, three, there you have it. It'll pop right on out. Here are the die cuts, all nice and cleaned up a bit. The set comes from 1 to 0 and includes a 6 and a 9 as well. Most sets with other companies don't actually include it, which is actually pretty nice because then you don't have to cut or wait to cut your 6 or your 9. Are as follows. If you want to get a better idea of the size and measurements, go ahead and push pause. Here's a few samples of cards that were made using this die set. I hope you enjoy. Thank you. for watching. We hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe and follow along. You can also visit us online at craftingdesertdivas.com.